means that your first day back next week, we will have a quiz. Please turn in your review sheet from yesterday, and you have no incompletes. Now today, Kris, we are going to take a test and start five. All right, Kris, it's up to you. You may take the test during my pre-cal class, or you may take the quiz during my geometry class. Okay, it's up to you. Now we're starting chapter five today, just so you know, Kris. Chapter five is about congruent triangles and special segments in a triangle. We won't be learning many ways to prove that two triangles are congruent. We won't be learning what congruent triangles are and how to understand which parts of these triangles are congruent to each other. We will also learn how to use congruent triangles to solve problems. Okay? Now the video today, Kris, specifically is about congruent triangles. We will learn a definition. We will learn how to write a congruent statement. And we're going to learn how to take a congruent statement that's given to you and then match up corresponding angles and corresponding sides. So that's what we're going to do today, Kris. I want you to watch this video right here, okay? Here's the homework I want you to do. The homework is due tomorrow, okay? And so here's the homework right here. Here's a help video. Now, Kris, let's quickly go over your quiz from yesterday. Kris, as you can tell on your quiz, you did make a 65. Now, when students do poorly in my class, I don't get mad. I don't get mad at them. I don't treat them differently. I don't chew them out. I simply say this: Kris, you will pass or fail my class on your own merit, okay? You're going to have to decide whether you want to do the work or not, okay? And so, I love all my students, care about them, I'm here to help you. Let's go over your quiz. Hopefully what I say right now will help you, okay? So first of all, you missed number four. I'm not going to go over that with you because you can look that up in your notes, okay? Number five, let's talk about this, all right? Now, please pay close attention. Let me help you, Kris. Please learn, okay? Watch. All of these lines are called centroids, okay? I'm using a mouse, Kris, so my writing is going to be a little sloppy, okay? Centroids, okay? Now, what we learned is this. This line here, this part here, will always be twice as big as this part here, okay? Same thing here. The longer line here is twice as big as this line here. The longer is twice as big as this line here. So with that in mind, I told you here that JK is 4. So from here to here is 4. Now, Kris, think about what I just said. If this blue line is a centroid, which it is, then this longer segment here is twice as big as this. So if this is 4, then from here to here, it has to be what? 8. Now, find JG. So from J to G, the length would be 12, right? From here to here is 4. From here to here is 8. Add those together, you get 12. So there's one answer. Now find the length of KG. So here's K, here's G. That length is what? 8. So the answer would be 8. Okay, Kris, I hope that helps. Now, this last problem here you missed, so let me help you with this, Kris. Please watch this. Now look, anytime I give you a triangle and I ask you, not a triangle, sorry, anytime I give you the three sides measurements of a triangle and I ask you, is the triangle obtuse or acute or right? It's really simple what you do, Kris. Please watch this. You take the two smaller sides, in this case it's 4 and 7, and you square them and add them together. That's so easy, okay? So 4 times 4 is 16, 7 times 7 is 49. Add those together and you will get 65. Got it, Kris? Then you take the longer side, you put it over here, and you square it. 12 times 12 is 144. And then you compare these two numbers, Are you ready, Chris? Write this down, learn, okay? If this side over here is less than, if these two numbers squared and added together is less than this over here, if it's less than, then the triangle is always going to be obtuse. Write that down, okay? If this number here is greater than, then the triangle is going to be acute. Okay? If they're equal, then the triangle is right. Got it? A right triangle. Now we know 65 is what? Less than 144, so we know this triangle is obtuse. I hope that helps, Chris, okay? All right, let's finish this up. That's all for today, Chris. Please get to work on your test notes and homework. Have a great day. Contact me if you have any questions.